Hey guys, I'm Nicole. Welcome back to my channel. Most of you know that I was Miss Washington 2017, but I don't think a lot of you know how I got started in pageants. So today, I want to tell you that story and kind of walk you through the journey of how I made it to Miss America. You just gotta live. I remember getting a brochure in the mail for an organization called National American Miss, and my sister was so interested in it and she really wanted to do it. And so my parents sat us down to have this conversation about doing this pageant. So at the time, Trading Spaces Family Edition was on. Were any of you guys fans of that show? I loved it and I really wanted to see the Family Edition, and I really was not interested in this pageant. So I quickly said, I'm not interested, bye Felicia, and I left into my parents' room to go watch Trading Spaces Family Edition. My sister signed up for the pageant and we went to Seattle to watch, and I remember looking at my mom in the audience and I said, never sign me up for one of these. I was so terrified. I never wanted to be on stage speaking in a microphone. It just looked so scary to me. But as I watched my sister compete, I saw how much confidence she was gaining and how many friends she was making, and it truly did look really fun. So I asked my mom if I can compete, and I did my first one in 2005 as a junior preteen. I thought I was the bee's knees. I thought I was so cool. I did the state pageant and qualified for nationals and never got my name called. So I went back to state and I got fourth runner up. I went to nationals feeling really good, still didn't get my name called. So I went back to state as a preteen. It was my last year in that age division and I got third runner up. But I still qualified for nationals, so we went back down to California for nationals. And for the first time in all the years I had competed, I made it into the top 10. I was so thrilled just to have my name called and to have made it one step closer than I ever had before. And truthfully, I thought I was going home in the top 10. But as they narrowed it down to five girls, and then 4, 3, 2.
She's your first runner-up, and she is Caitlin Webb. Ladies and gentlemen, your new National All-American preteen is Nicole Ritter. There she is, ladies and gentlemen. Get used to seeing her face. She visits us from Washington, but now she'll be representing the country.
The first title that I ever won was the National All-American Miss Preteen. That experience kind of flipped my whole life upside down because I was able to travel with them on their summer tour and go to 6 different states representing their organization. And through that, my sister got a job with them as a choreographer. When I turned 16, I also got to start working with my sister. And now every summer, I travel to different states around the country and put on the National American Miss state pageants.
I'm sitting backstage right now here at National American Miss, and I get to sit backstage during the times where I'm not on stage hosting the shows and help all the girls out. You guys, I'm backstage with the junior teens. They're about to go on for the show. They're so pumped. Woo!
A couple years ago, they started treating me to be an MC, so sometimes I also get to MC some of the shows, which is so much fun. The skills I learned at National American Miss and all the things I gained from that organization is what truly prepared me and set me up to be successful in Miss America. They taught me how to interview. They taught me how to speak in public. They taught me how to walk into a room full of strangers that I don't know and then walk out with a ton of new friends. National American Miss gave me the confidence I needed to believe I had what it took to make it to Miss America. After I gave up my title with National American Miss, I joined the Outstanding Teen Program, which is the younger sister program to Miss America. It was actually pretty unique because my sister was Miss Washington's Outstanding Teen in 2010, and I competed in 2011 and won, so she crowned me. And we were the first sisters to crown each other back to back in the history of the organization. I'm gonna be 100% honest, I genuinely did not plan or expect to win that year. I thought, my sister's the queen, they're not gonna let me win. And then when I won, I didn't really know what to do because I was a lot younger than I had planned in my head when I would be if I ever got to go to Miss America's Outstanding Teen. So I had this awkward gap year where I was too young to do Miss, but I had already done the teen program. And so I learned about an organization called Distinguished Young Women. It used to be called America's Junior Miss, and it's one of the nation's largest scholarship programs. Fun little fact, Diane Sawyer was America's Junior Miss 1963. And this organization gives away thousands of dollars in college scholarships to young girls. So I Googled Distinguished Young Women, and and signed up for our local program. There ended up being no girls in the local, so they sent me straight to state. And then I actually ended up winning state. I was the Distinguished Young Woman of Washington in 2013, which sent me to the national competition in Mobile, Alabama. Y'all, I had never been to Alabama before, and honestly, I thought I would never go back. And so my whole mindset was, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm not gonna win this thing. I'm just gonna go to the South, eat some barbecue, and have some fun. And when I got to Mobile, I tell you, I fell in love with this organization. I didn't know a lot about it, but there's so much history in the city of Mobile. And as I learned about these people and what they've done for young women across the country, I became so passionate for the program. People who don't really know what the organization is, with National American Miss, Outstanding Teen, Miss America, and Distinguished Young Woman, just think it's a beauty pageant. They think that you just get all dressed up, and then when you win, you just walk around and wave at people. And that's not what it does at all. The programs I've been involved in have helped fund young women's education. They've sent them to college and they've launched their careers. One of the biggest reasons America's Junior Miss changed their name to Distinguished Young Women is so that they didn't sound so much like a pageant, so that they could welcome all types of girls who wanted to receive funding for their education. On the final night, they had called 9 names of the top 10 and they still hadn't called mine. And I was okay with not being in the top, but the 10th name was Washington and I made it through the top and I got to recompete in all the phases of the competition. And then when it came down to it, they called the top 3. And I thought, that could have done well enough for second runner up, but they called Florida. And so I thought, shoot, first runner up is so hard. I don't think I did that well, but I could use $15,000. They called South Carolina. And so I wrote it off. I mean, I was standing at the very edge of the line holding on to Colorado's hand, and Mississippi was 4 girls down from me, and she was the cutest girl. I mean, she had it together the whole 2 weeks and everyone loved her because she's the Southern girl and just sweet as can be. And I knew in my heart that it was Mississippi. And they said, the Distinguished Young Woman of America for 2013 is Washington. I didn't believe them. I was standing right next to the host, and it's almost like I didn't hear them. And Colorado looks at me and she says, that's you! And I won the whole thing. And so you guys, that night I won $39,500 in scholarships, and they helped pay for my education at Chapman. One of the biggest reasons, actually the main reason why I was able to graduate debt-free. Nowhere in my life did I have that in my plans. I never thought I would do that program, but it changed my life. And I spent my freshman year at Chapman representing the Distinguished Young Woman organization, traveling close to every weekend, speaking and volunteering and visiting senators in Washington, D.C. I lived in the state of Alabama for a few months and fell in love with that community there. If you're watching from Mobile, hello, I miss you guys so much. But that's a really incredible organization if you are in high school. Your junior year is the year you apply, so look into it. I actually know a lot of you have been following me since the Distinguished Young Woman Day, so if you knew me through that program, would you comment below and say hi? I'd love to know where you're from and if you competed or maybe what your story is. After that, I did take a couple years off because it was a very exhausting year and I didn't really like the idea of going right into Miss America. So I took a couple years off to be in college and be Nicole, and then I went on to do Miss California, Miss Washington, and then, as you know, Miss America. So that's how I got started. There's a lot more that goes into that story when I started my Miss America journey. So if that is something that you'd like to hear about, let me know in the comment description below. Maybe I'll make a video in the future talking about my actual journey to Miss America. Thank you so much for watching. If you're thinking about competing in a pageant, maybe you have some questions, leave them also in the comment description below. I'd be happy to help, and I'd love to hear where you're competing and what you're doing. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and find me on Instagram at Nicole the Nomad. There's tons more fun adventures and pictures on there. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time. I just wanna leave, yeah.